Hi guys, welcome to the unboxing and quick review of this loyalty portable air conditioner. It's listing on Amazon, says rechargeable evaporative air conditioner fan with 3-speed, 7 colors, cordless personal air cooler with handle for home. It's listed for around $46. Has pretty good reviews, but sometimes I have the impression that a lot of these reviews are just fake and they are not very honest, because some of these reviews are really, really bad. I mean, I'm not saying that these things cannot work, but they have a couple of, or at least one major disadvantage. So before you buy such a thing, I mean, it's not only about the Laozi, it's about all these portable air conditioners. This is a big, big problem with them, and I will tell you this at the end of the video or somewhere in the video definitely. So make sure you watch the whole video till the very end, so you're not missing out on the biggest disadvantage which these things have. And a lot of people are not aware of what's the big problem here. So but I wanted to test this thing out and show you how the thing works or how it's not working. So here's the description, specification, also the site, model type WTF26. Yeah, that's about it. It can be bought in different colors. I mean, these things come in many, many different colors and shapes, and they are not even very expensive. Some of these you can buy sometimes at $25 or so. So here's the thing. So I've been charging this air cooler now for a little bit, and you can see this red light, and it had already turned into, I think it was blue, so indicating that it's fully charged. I mean, we get also this USB-C charging cable, which looks pretty good actually. I have used my own, doesn't matter. So here is how this thing looks. I mean, here we see the parts. We have this filter here, that's something which can be made wet. I mean, you can really submerge it before you're using it, and it will start to cool sooner. This is how it goes into this thing. Here we have this tank, or however this is called, to collect a little bit of too much water, especially when you had it soaked. And then you put it here, it probably will collect a little bit of water. So this is good that it doesn't leak too much, but I would have loved this a little bit higher. This is not very high, but I mean, there's not really water running from here down. It's just sprayed. You don't have to be worried. I mean, I'm going to show you that here. I mean, it's fully charged, so we can actually turn it on here with this button here, and then it starts spinning. You can see it has three levels. This is pretty much standard with most of these things here. There's a strong fan here. The good thing is that it's on level one. It's really quiet. Here I have it on level one. It's barely noticeable, especially when it's closed. It's not even as loud as the AC running in the back. What we have here, that's where the water is coming out. I mean, it's more like a sprayed water. We'll see how this is, more like a spray or fog. And then it comes down behind this filter here, and then it will like make this thing a little bit wet, and then it's evaporating and coming out a little bit cooler. That's the idea here. So I'm going to do that here. Now it's fully dry, and you can see that here. For me, somehow this looks like an ultrasound nebulizer. So I'm going to fill this up here. Of course, I'm turning this off, and I fill just water. The best is to use filtered water or even steam distilled water. So I'm going to turn this thing on here and go a little bit down with the camera. I mean, by the way, if you have to empty this, especially if, every time you are transporting this, make sure that the water always flows to the front where there is no electronic. I mean, here in the back, we have all these buttons here, and if you would pour it out to the back, it would flow over the buttons and probably destroy the unit. You have to be really careful with this thing. So again, I'm turning this thing on, which actually starts the fan and the water spray function, and there's nothing to see, so not with the camera and also not for me. Just when I hold my finger here, maybe you can see that it's spraying very, very fine. I think it's not like a fog, it's not like a foker or so. Yeah, it's similar, but it's spraying a little bit down. So, and with the wind, the whole thing is coming out. So probably you could even use that without this filter here. I think it wouldn't really get wet. That would probably work. This would be similar to the situation or the things like the equipment which you see sometimes in the restaurants, where you have this strong fan and then a little bit of water spraying. I think this would be very similar to that. I don't see a lot of water, so if this thing is really dirty and maybe even moldy and you don't find a replacement for that, I think you can just leave it out and have still some cooling effect here. But as long as it's working, I would suggest to use it here. So this is how to add this thing. I mean, we have this thing from the top, the filter, and then we slide this thing in. There's not even some kind of sensor checking if everything is there. So we have these different speeds here. We have the green, that's the second speed. We have the blue, which is the strongest speed. Then we can have it with the water or without the water. Here is, I think, as long as we see this, it's with the water. And here we have the different light. After short pressing, it will cycle through all the different lights. And if you're happy with a color, you just long press and you see this just like flickering short, and then it will stay the same. So you can see there is some air coming out. So I guess there is probably a lot of water going down now. Probably it's spraying really hard. So go a little bit closer. I hope you can see that. That's pretty extreme. Yeah, I didn't expect that, and I don't know why this is. I mean, this lid here, which you have to place on top, is not fully closing this thing. So there's actually no need for some kind of air exchange through the thing, but they have probably just made this as a like a safety measure that it cannot produce some kind of vacuum and then not work anymore. So I think you can definitely leave this here. Yeah, this is pretty interesting to see why this thing or how this thing works. So when we take it out again, let's see how wet this thing is, and we can see, yeah, there's a little bit of water here, especially in this area concentrated, but of course after some time it will spread out everywhere. But if you want to have quick cooling, yeah, then better soak it with a little bit of water. So now it's time where it gets really interesting. I've been running this for a couple of minutes, not too long. I mean, if you leave it running for a longer time, it should be working a little bit more or like stronger. So I have this laser temperature meter here, and I'm going to test the water here. And you can see it shows around 80 degrees Fahrenheit, yeah, 80.1, 80.4. You can see it's pretty warm. I mean, it's basically the room temperature. It's pretty hot inside here, yeah, it's a little bit above 80. Now we are going down where the air is coming out, and we are checking here again, and you can see, depending on where it is, yeah, it was more or less my finger. I moved this thing a little bit to the back so we can measure this better. I hope you can see that. So we have definitely lower temperatures. If we hit like the center area where there is already water in the filter, we get down to around 76. Definitely a difference to everything else around, like the room temperature. It's lower than room temperature, definitely. I mean, I can also try somewhere else. You can see it. Room temperature definitely around 80, and here the air which is coming out, it's cooler, definitely a couple of degrees. It's not extreme. So this proves actually that it's working. So why would I then doubt that this thing doesn't have a real nice positive impact? And the problem is that everything, the air which is coming out here, has a much higher humidity rate. And there's a big correlation between the humidity and the temperature which you feel. So the higher the humidity is, the higher is actually the felt temperature. And if you take this maybe 76 degrees here, which is in the center, I mean, yeah, 77, sometimes 76, probably depending on where we measure. Here 76. When you add the additional humidity which is coming out from here, then it's more or less same felt temperature which you have already around this device. I mean, for short time, especially for short time, maybe it feels a little bit cooler. It almost feels like an AC. The big problem is that over time, if you have like a closed room, the humidity is accumulating and it's adding up and up and up, and after a couple of hours there will be so much humidity that first thing it won't work anymore. So it won't really cool down the air anymore when the humidity is too high, and second thing is humidity is still increasing and increasing, and then it feels even warmer than where you have been starting. You have to be really careful about that. The only way this thing really works is when you have enough air exchange, nice ventilation in a room, maybe through an open window, but of course you have to make sure that there's not additional heat coming in. So usually the best thing is if you have this thing working in an environment which is already air conditioned, where you have always some kind of air circulation, a nice dry air, so there's no problem with the excess humidity. And so this can work for a small workplace, yeah, there's absolutely no question about that. There's just science, it's physics, it really works. It's no magic. It has always been working. These things have been used since decades or even longer. Now they are here a little bit in a nicer, more comfortable device. And if you need that, I mean, just for a small workplace, isolated area, especially in a room which is air conditioned anyway, maybe you have just the hottest place in an office which is air conditioned, then this thing could work. And it's only $25. Yeah, why not? But only for this, and not like if you have a small bedroom and you think, okay, you can cool this thing down the whole night without any air exchange. No, definitely won't work. That's not going to happen. I mean, during the time when you want to fall asleep, maybe it's working for half an hour or so, but then you have to fall asleep, otherwise it's getting warmer and warmer. Yeah, here, by the way, I have the instruction. I haven't been showing you that, it's a little bit difficult to read, but maybe it still helps if you're interested into that. I mean, it's just Chinese, no name. I don't expect that they have any kind of website, so that's the whole thing you have. Maybe it helps a little bit. And yeah, so that's it actually for now. If you're interested into that, I'll put down the link to the Amazon listing of this device down into the description, so you can check it out or drive from there if you like it. And I hope I've been able to help you a little bit with this video. If you have any questions or comments, just write to the comment section below. I'm always happy to talk about these things. And if you like the video, give me a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.